we're back with a tight close-up.
On camera two again?
Yeah, don't you think?
Well, I really like spontaneity, so I want you to surprise me.
Surprise you?
Yes, give it your best shot.
So you don't want to know the shot?
No, I'll find the camera, don't worry.
All righty then.
That's why she's Eric.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, it's not even Erica anymore. It is the cutting edge with Erica. You could choke on it.
Oh.
It's too long. It doesn't have any punch. I mean, Erica was perfect. It just had pizzazz, and it really said volume.
Erica, we've been through this before.
Well, humor me, Tad. Humor me.
Our research shows that single name titles make people think of talk shows, and we want our audience to be able to expect more than that.
Ice dancing acts. Am I throwing it?
Trends up to the second info box.
Precisely.
The title's too long. Dad, you can start now.
Hi, thanks for coming.
Oh, well, I wouldn't have missed this for all the chocolate in Fanny Farmer's Warehouse.
Where's the studio audience?
You're it.
Oh, my goosebumps are getting goosebumps. There's just something so magical about TV.
Seems to me that the wasteland's getting faster.
Honestly, just hush up. I am all a tingle. I feel like Mary is about to toss her hat in the air or Dick is about to trip over his ottoman. I mean, look at her. Just look. She's history's chosen goddess. She's calm. She's cool. She's collected.
That's our Erica. Miss Kane.
What?
Miss Kane.
Yeah?
It's terrible. It's horrible. Don't hurt me.
Myron, you're really distracting me. You're breaking my concentration.
Tom Hanks's people called our people.
My people.
He's still in Rome.
What?
He's terribly sorry, but his plane was grounded.
He's sorry? No, this can't be happening. I want him here now. I need him here now. This is a joke. This is just a bad, sick joke. Did you hear?
I think all of North America just heard.
Okay. We have been advertising him all week.
Stay calm. I know. Tell me about it, okay, honey? We'll come up with something.
What are we going to come up with? There's nothing to come up with. How am I going to premiere my show without a guest star? Well, I'm not. That's all. I can't, because I'm going to be a laughingstock of the entire industry, Tad. What are you going to do? You're the producer. Do something. We have got 2 minutes until my show premieres, and I'm without a guest star. I've done all this preparation on this interview. I even know what cream rinse he uses.
I'm sure he'll make it up to you, Erica.
Darling, it's not a question of making it up. I am left without a guest star. I have a big hole in the middle of my program. 1 minute, people. One minute.
I have no time to fix it.
Places, everyone. Places.
You're going to be great, okay? You are all the star this show will ever need.
Absolutely. They are tuning in to see you.
Oh, they're going to see me, all right. They're going to see me with half a show. I'm going to look like a fool.
We go in 30, people. 30.
You into doing this live.
Spontaneity, remember? Nobody wings it like Erica Kane.
Yeah, to wing this, I'd have to be a condor. I am, aren't I?
And never anything else.
Miss Kane, please.
Yes.
All right, here we go. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Welcome to the cutting edge. Today's show promises to be just as exciting and unpredictable as our fashions this year. It's also going to be just as much fun as legally we can have. And it's going to be as fantasy-filled as the fast-approaching millennium. Imagine it's less than 5 years away. Are you going to be ready for the 21st century?
Aaron, how are you? This is Dimitri Merritt.
Hey, Dimitri, how's it going?
It's going great.
How's that lovely wife of yours?
Oh, she's absolutely terrific.
Great.
Listen, I have a huge favor to ask of you.
All My Children, brought to you by Bounty, the quilted quicker picker-upper.
Welcome back. Isn't this wonderful? This was presented to me just this morning by our first guest. If you happen to be in Paris, I'm sure that you recognize this. Light, feminine, elegant, the hit of the season in Paris. Joining me now is our first guest, the man behind the hem, the famed fashion designer, and my very, very dear friend, D. Jacques Martin. Jacques. Oh, Jacques.
Erica.
It's so wonderful to see you
here.
Well,
it's wonderful to be here.
Thank you. I am so excited about your line.
I, too, am excited. Finally, a woman of the world can be elegant and comfortable at the same time.
Aaron, I can't thank you enough.
Dimitri, the pleasure's all mine.
I'll see you then.
Sell everything you own and move to Paris to study fashion.
How's she doing?
You kidding? She's a natural. You put that woman in front of a camera and you can't stop her.
And so I understand that you took a rundown apartment and left. Jacques, I could just go on talking with you all day about fashion. But I think we've had enough talk, don't you? Wouldn't you like to flaunt your line?
I would love it. That's why I'm here.
Well, I didn't want to bore you while I slipped in and out of countless dresses.
I would not have been bored.
Jacques, you have to behave yourself. In any case, we taped a fashion segment a little bit earlier. Jacques, we can watch right here on the monitor.
Move your system, taste the spaces. When I'm on the mic, you can't refuse. No, I didn't gain a reach, I came to amuse. Techno making, no mistaking, never faking, always breaking it down. Up to a party, now let my beat control your body.
We wear your hats, the way you sip your tea, the memory of all that. No, they can't take that away from me. I'll build a stairway to paradise with a new step every day. I'm gonna get there at any price. Stand aside, I'm on my way.
Bravo, John.
Bravo, Erica. And thank you. If all the women who wear my creations were as lovely as you.
Thank you. I'd be out of a job. Really, on behalf of women everywhere, Jacques, I must thank you for bringing comfort to all that beautiful elegance.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you. Will we see you in the fall with your newest collection?
But of course.
Thank you. Gee, Jacques Martin, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, you are so wonderful. Well, my stage manager is going like this. And with good reason. Ladies and gentlemen, I promised you today this show would be very exciting, very unpredictable. And indeed, that's what we have here. Tom Hanks, as you know, was supposed to be on our show and, well, things happen. And his plane has been grounded in Rome. But he has promised to appear on the show just as soon as his schedule permits. And he will. And that's why our stage manager is going like this. But since I have a few moments, I would like to address an issue that has been bothering me for quite some time. I know you know what I'm talking about. Women who dress like models but wear makeup like truck drivers. I know you understand this, and it doesn't have to be like this anymore. We can fix this with some very, very easy tips. Tell me something. Do I have a volunteer from one of my staff? Wouldn't one of you like to come up just for a quick, easy makeover? Oh, come on, just a makeover on national television? No. Okay. Well, then I guess I'll just have to pick my volunteers the way they pick volunteers in the Army. Oh, come on. You're in the Army now. You're going to love this. You're going to be wonderful.
Not really.
Now, I just want to tell everybody at home, don't adjust your sets, because this is what she's really wearing.
I didn't come here to be insulted.
No, of course not. But just first of all, we're going to eliminate the competition. We're going to get rid of this. Ooh. And the earring.
Ooh.
And the beads. All the beads. And I think the hair bow should go. Because, you know, the truth is, I do think that hair bows just look better on little girls. You know, little girls who are under 10 years old, let's say. And, okay, we lost that. You're going to keep this little shrug number?
Yes, I think I better keep
okay,
that.
Well, really, you know what the main rule is? The main rule is just accentuate the positive.
Well,
yes, look at that. Gorgeous red hair. We finish up by lining the lips and filling them in. And of course, it would really help if I actually had a lip liner. Oh, wonderful.
Excuse me for just one moment. I'd like to...
What? Do I look all right?
Introduce someone?
Well, hello.
Aaron. Aaron Neville.
Oh, let me stop by.
I don't have any lip liner, but I do have a lip.
Oh! Oh, in the warmest, dreamiest voice, it could just melt the polar ice.
Well, thank you.
What are you doing here?
Well, a friend of mine called and said he needed a hand, so, well, here I am.
Oh, well, I hope your goodness thing make the man sing.
I never say no to a lovely lady. What would you like to hear?
How about your rain song?
Oh, my latest single.
Yeah, I'm up on your music.
Well, I like that one myself, so no problem. Thank you.
Oh.
You can think that I'm just playing games. You can think I do you wrong. You can think that I don't mean a word I say. You can think what you want. But if you think you're gonna stop the way I feel about you, baby, you're just wasting your time. 'Cause I'm not changing my mind. Can't stop the rain. That I'm gonna stay around. You can trust that I treat you right. You can be sure that I won't ever let you down. Sure, there were stars in the night. And if you think there'll ever come a day I'll live without you, baby, you're as wrong as can be. Can't change the way that I feel. Can't stop the
fun. I really hope that you've had as much fun as we have here. I thank my first guest, super designer, D.
Jacques Martin, my very patient friend Opal Courtland, with her spur-of-the-moment makeover, and last but not least, our unexpected and extremely welcome guest, Aaron Neville. Thank you. Join us next time on The Cutting Edge.
Sensation.
Oh, it's so much fun. I feel like I've been on a roller coaster ride for the past hour.
Yes.
Can I do it again?
Well, it looks like you're going to have to because our switchboard is lit up like Times Square on New Year's Eve. Erica, you are a hit.
Yeah.